take time to be holy. Speak of with thy Lord. Abide in him always, and feed on his word. Make friends of God's children. Help those who are weak, forgetting in nothing his blessing to see. Take time to be holy. The world rushes on. Spend much time in secret with Jesus alone. By looking to Jesus, like him thou shalt be. Thy friends in thy conduct his likeness shall see. Take time to be holy. Let him be thy guide, and run not before him, whatever betide, in joy or in sorrow. Still follow thy Lord, and looking to Jesus, still trust in his word. Take time to be holy. Be calm in thy soul. Each thought and each temper beneath his control. Thus, led by his Spirit, the fountains of love, thou shalt soon be fitted for service above.
Jesus' name we pray. You can remain standing while I tell you these things. Amen. About 3 days ago, we had the visitation of Jesus. Amen. And his words went like this. I am happy with the work you are doing for me. The word you preach, which I have put in your mouth, has awakened many to righteousness. Amen. People know me in the world, but that is mere knowledge without righteousness and holiness. But now, through your preaching, many now seek my righteousness, holiness, and truth. Both within and outside holiness revival movement. Amen. It came to a time in heaven I regretted to have created man on the earth. I would suffer a lot to bring one person to salvation. But today, many souls are crying to me everywhere. Many souls are crying to me everywhere for salvation, restitution, having heard the true word. People now desire to go to heaven. I am happy with you. Hallelujah. Amen. Don't mind those leaving holiness revival movement. I am the one removing them in order to hasten my work. Amen. I am the one removing them in order to hasten my work in the movement. My coming is at hand. In the days of Moses, I removed the unfaithful among my children who delayed their journey to the promised land. I am removing the unfaithful in Horemon. Amen. No man can hurt you, for I am with you. Fear not what they are saying and what you are hearing. I am pleased with you. Now I can find people who are preaching me with holy hearts. Not only one person, but many through your preaching. I am happy, happy, happy. Discovering abundant life for yourself and others. Discovering abundant life for yourself and others. Jesus actually did say, I came that I might give them life, and that I may give them more abundantly. It will surprise you to know that there is abundant life available at your disposal, but unknown and unattainable to you. You are famishing in want. You are piling away due to lack and scarcity. You are piling away due to poverty and frustration. But you can suddenly become different. I believe today is your day. You will suddenly become different. You will suddenly become better. You will suddenly become a happy person. Yes. Peace and joy will suddenly flood into your heart. When you discover the source of life that gives satisfaction, rest, peace, and fullness. Allow God to open your eyes. Yeah. Pray to God to open your eyes to abundant life for yourself and others. Yes, there is the challenge. There's the challenge of life. As we see it in Genesis chapter 21. Genesis chapter 21. I read verse 14 to verse 16. And Abraham rose up early in the morning and took bread and a bottle of water and gave it unto Hagar, putting it on her shoulder, and the child, and sent her away. And she departed and wandered in the wilderness of Beersheba. Your case is the case of a wanderer. You are wandering from place to place. You are wandering from city to city. Maybe even nation to nation. What was this woman wandering about? Scarcity. Scarcity. For verse 15 says, and the water was spent in the bottle, and she cast the child under one of the shrubs. There was scarcity. There was no water to drink. Water had finished. She was wandering about in the wilderness looking for water. Necessity of life. Essential of life. She was wandering. You are looking for necessity of life. Your heart is thirsty. Your heart is thirsty. Your stomach is hungry. And you are going up and down looking for something. Hagar was looking for water. You are looking for the water of life. It is the water of life. You have been wandering from church to church, wandering from town to town, wandering from city to city. You are looking for the water of life. Hagar could not find. Hagar could not find. And her child, Ishmael, had lost all the strength available. He had cried and cried, crying to a helpless woman. You are crying to a helpless church. You are crying to helpless men of God. You are crying under an ignorant man of God that is helpless in your case, helpless about your eternal life, helpless about your salvation, helpless about your deliverance, helpless about eternal hope. You are crying in vain. You are crying in vain. Until Hagar in verse 16, and she went and sat down over against him in a good way off, as it were a bow shot. For she said, let me not see the date of the child. And she sat over against him and lift up her voice and wept. There are people weeping here because they have been looking for salvation they cannot find. Their pastors have made so many promises unto them. It's not working. They gave them fasting to fast. They have fasted for 7 days. They have fasted for 21 days. They have fasted for 70. They have fasted 120 days. No salvation. No way out. Once a sinner, still a sinner. Up to now a sinner. The meaning of Jesus is not yet clear. The Bible has no meaning. The promises are dead to you. They're not working. They're not working. Woe is me, I am undone. Your voice is being heard as you sob in your privacy. Because hell is yours. You confess. For what must I do? What can I do? Hagar has spent up all her strength. What can she do now? You have spent up all your strength. You have played all Christianity as you know. It has not changed you. It has not changed you. That is the challenge. That was the challenge. Except the Lord intervenes personally over your case, who will help you? Except there can be divine intervention in your situation, who will deliver you? Devil is rejoicing with your name. He's taunting you that he's waiting for you. Yes, he has doomed you. You have sinned indeed, but have you come out? That was the situation, the challenge. That's the challenge. Until the Lord intervened. Verse 17, and God heard the voice of the Lord. And the angel of God called to Hagar out of heaven and said unto her, what aileth thee, Hagar? Why are you crying? What's wrong? What's the problem? The voice of that child has been heard. There's a merciful God in heaven that knows that their people are famishing from thirst. Their people are dying of thirst. God has heard that voice in heaven. The voice of people crying from city to city, nation to nation, crying unto God because there's no water of life. There's no water of life. Eternal life cannot be found. They can't find eternal life in the church anymore. Men of God are not having any power to give eternal life. They don't have the word of eternal life. Cry from city to city. Your voice is among them. You're looking for original Christianity. Like Gideon, where are the days of his miracle? Where are the days of his power? Where are the days of his holiness? Where are the days of his purity? Where are the days of the Lord? Of his deliverances? Did he not deliver Israel from Egypt by his mighty power? Did he not cross them from the Red Sea? He dried up the Red Sea for them to cross. Where is the power of salvation? You cry. For God hath heard the voice of the Lord where he is. Arise, lift up the Lord and hold him in thy hand. For I will make him a great nation. Everybody raise up their hands and wave at this great God, who is still promising you a future, who is still attaching some wonderful promise in your life, and he say he's going to make you a great man, he's going to make you a great woman. Oh, you who have lost all hope, you who think you're going to hell, the Lord said I will cancel hell in your life. You will die no more, but you will live. You will be useful in my hand. Yes. And God opened her eyes, and she saw a well of water. And she went and filled the bottle with water and gave the lad drink. You are going to drink. You will drink the mercy of God. You will drink the water of the forgiveness of God. You will drink the water of eternal life. That's God. Matter is settled. Challenge of scarcity. You are seeing scarcity of real love. That's what you see in the world around you. Scarcity of real love. You see hatred, bitterness, unforgiveness, oppression, and treachery everywhere in the society. Love is absent. People are insincere to you and to fellow ones. Family members are in war with each other. People are unkind and uncharitable. They are stingy. They are selfish. No love anywhere for yourself. Not even in the church. No, in the man of God you trusted. You see no love. Love is scarce. like the water of Hagar. You go about wandering looking for love you cannot find. Today, the gracious God shall open your eyes. You will find a well of love to your satisfaction, to quench your thirst, that you die no more. You will no more perish because there's no love. You will find a well of love springing up to everlasting life. I'm talking about the challenge of scarcity. Scarcity of truth. Truth is falling in the street. The flag of truth raised up by many churches has fallen down. It's lying down flat. Indicating truth is no more here. You are looking for truth. Can't I know the truth? For the Bible says, ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. And I want to know the truth to all in order to be free. I cannot find. Truth is curse. You go through the books written even by people that say they are inspired. You finish the book, there's no truth there. You listen to great Christian orators, people of renown. You are not hearing words of truth. You see a society that hates the truth, that speaks against the truth, that does not follow the truth, that fights against the truth. You find a church, the church you were born into, fighting the truth of eternal life. Fighting. The ministers of God you see closely, learn the truth about God and His word. You serve many of these ministers. You follow them closely, pouring water into their hands, wishing that you could be a minister like them, but you are disappointed because they are ministers of unrighteousness. There's no truth in them. Are you then going to inherit a lie? Will you be anointed by a liar? Was Elijah a sinner that handed over to Elisha? But where is your mentor like that? Your hope is that he's going to train you up like himself. And with all the years he has spent in the Lord, he's a liar. You are confused. Truth is falling in the street. The church you see or attend is not given to complete truth. Somebody can best come to say a portion of truth. Like somebody talk about this, one of these churches, one of these largest churches in Nigeria. He said he had been in the church for 11 years. Nobody talks about the second coming of Jesus. All is prosperity. Green prosperity, yellow prosperity, white prosperity, black prosperity. Which one again? Seven colors of the rainbow. Prosperity. Nobody. He said it was one preacher that came and talked that Jesus was coming again. One preacher in 11 years. That's your situation. There's no truth. How will you be free? There's no truth. How will you get to heaven? It is the truth that gives eternal life. And now that you don't know truth, where is life? You will not have it. How can you be free? You cannot. How can you be free from Satan? You cannot, because it's truth that delivers. You cannot. Yeah. The flag of truth, even in Christian churches and ministries, has been laid down. But my brother, my sister, there is a well of truth around. The well of Hagar. A well of everlasting truth. There is that well around. Just around your corner, your eyes are not open. Oh Lord, open his eyes. Oh Lord, open her eyes. Scarcity of righteousness. Scarcity of righteousness. A sister called me that runs our program in My TV. She said, the voice of truth is extinct. That word was too strong. Because I was just considering, do we continue with My TV? We'll be there for 4 years. Is there any benefit? He said, listen, the TV station is giving you great respect. You are one of the most revered persons. Because the voice of holiness has become extinct. And when you pay for once, they play your messages twice. Don't withdraw. Consider it your soul. It touched me. That word extinct was too difficult for me. Difficult to swallow. Do you know extinct? This is terrible. Voice of holiness is extinct. So, you have noticed in yourself bankruptcy of righteousness. I heard you when you were saying, I am not righteous. That statement is disturbing. That statement is disturbing. When you said, I am not righteous. Righteousness is scarce. You have not found the path of righteousness. You have not. You have not found the path that leadeth to righteousness. You say, holiness, I am not holy. That statement is painful. It means our work has not finished in you. Because it's only when you are holy, you are qualified for heaven. Now that you boast, you say not boasting now, you are sincerely ignorant, you are sincerely speaking, that you are not holy, you are giving us great concern. It means this prescription we made for you is not working. The drugs of righteousness and holiness that we prescribed for you is not working. Maybe you're not taking it. It's likely you're not taking it. Or you're not taking it correctly. That's why you confess that. The people you hope to obtain from help from are also sinners like you. They are also sinners. When they come to preach, they say, nobody is righteous, including me.
And
then he begins to preach to you. It's like taking a dirty water to wash clothes. What are you going to realize from those clothes? The water is black and dirty. It's the one you're using to wash clothes with. What will you realize from that cloth? But that's the best available. In the land of the blind, the one with one eye is the king. Your pastors are blind with one eye. All the pastors in your denominations have one eye each. They are trying. You say, hey, we have wonderful pastors. How will they not be wonderful since you're blind? Are they not better than you? But when they go to where pastors are, they will be kept aside. That is it. You are now in a state of confusion. There's no righteousness on the earth. That's what you say. No, non-righteous. You conclude. Then you want to stay on your own. We're not going to church anymore. Which church does better? Where do I find righteousness? Where do I find righteousness? The rich man comes to church to be examined whether he is living well. He came and they make him assistant pastor. He said, I won't go to church again. I came so that I can be helped. I have become so good among them that I am assistant pastor. Then there's no truth in this thing they're doing. What do I know myself? What do I know? I'm telling you, righteousness is absent. That's what you're managing. The unfortunate thing is, they assure you in that condition that you're going to heaven. That's the worst thing your pastor has done for you. The worst thing is to assure you in the condition you are and say you are going to heaven, that you are a Christian, that you have been baptized, that you are eating Holy Communion, and that your name is in the book of life. That's the worst deceit of life. Thank God your eyes shall open today. Better know the truth now. That know it after this life, it will have no meaning anymore. Of what importance is remembering examination question after the examination? What is the use? You will rebuke your brain. You say, keep quiet. When I was looking for you, you didn't talk. It's after I have left, you say, hey, here is the answer. You are evil. As I say, you can enter into abundant life today. Hagar got it in the day. The voice of the Lord. The mercy of the Lord made the difference. I have heard the voice of the child. The voice of heaven make the difference. Hagar, Hagar, what's your problem? That voice of heaven made the difference in the life of Hagar. And the voice of heaven is speaking today. The voice of heaven is speaking today. And it shall make a difference in your life in Jesus' name. Yeah. In the book of Luke chapter 5. Luke chapter 5. From verse 1. The Bible tells us here. Saying. And it came to pass that As the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw two ships standing by the lake. But the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down, and taught the people out of the ship. Now, when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep, and lay down your nets for a draught. And Simon answering said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. And when they had this done, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, and their net break, and they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ship, that they should come and help them, and they came and filled both the ships, so that they began to sink. The difference has come. The difference has come. Peter and the fishermen with him had gone all night toiling, wandering upon the waters, like you wandering upon churches, from church to church. You wander from place to place. These ones were wandering on top of the waters, looking for fish and caught nothing. Looking for fish as you look for righteousness. Looking for fish as you look for truth. Looking for fish as you're looking for love. But they found none, until they came at the man of heaven, the one that came down from heaven. For no man has been to heaven but the Son of Man that came down from heaven. And they heard the voice of heaven, the voice of God speaking unto them. And that made the difference. Launch out your nets into the deep for a great catch. That word was the word of salvation. That word brought all the fishes for them. Fishes they would have taken days and days and weeks, even months to get, they got it in one day. Brother and sister, today is your day. I said, today is your day. That love you're looking for, your heart is looking for love, you will find it today. That the truth that you're looking for, you will find it today. The righteousness you're looking for, holiness, you will be clothed with it today. They enclosed so great fishes that they beckoned on others to come and help them. You will so be filled that you will turn a preacher. You will tell others. The woman of Samaria, so God filled that she needed to go and reduce part of it to the people of Samaria. It intoxicated her. You will be intoxicated with divine love. You will be intoxicated with divine truth. You will be intoxicated with righteousness. You will be filled. Blessed are ye that hunger and thirst after righteousness, for ye shall be filled. That is it. The difference was meeting with Jesus. you meet with Jesus today and receive his word of salvation. I have come that they might have life, that they might have it more abundantly. You meet with Jesus today and receive from him the power of salvation, that iniquity shall quench. I mean, that struggle shall quench. That opposing power shall be broken to pieces. You will be free. The righteousness you are looking for shall come. You will drink the water of life from Jesus. Receive from him eternal life. Receive from him the victory over sin. Receive from him victory over the devil. Receive from him victory over oppression, over sicknesses and diseases. Receive from Jesus total liberation, total freedom in the name of Jesus. Don't make that conclusion, Hagar, thinking that there's no water in the wilderness. I make rivers in the wilderness that I might give drink to my people. I make rivers. The God of heaven has provided the waters of life for you to drink. Your eyes have not opened. I am praying today that God will open your eyes, that you might see the waters of life, that you might drink and be satisfied and go and become a mini nation for Jesus. Hallelujah. The four lepers, they were in that situation. In the book of 2 Kings chapter 7, from verse 3 to verse 9. 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 3 to verse 9. And there were four leprous men at the entering in of the gate. And they said one to another, why sit we here until we die? If we say we will enter into the city, then the famine is in the city, and we shall die there. And if we sit still here, we die also. Now therefore, come and let us fall unto the host of the Syrians. If they save us alive, we shall live. And if they kill us, we shall but die. And they rose up in the twilight to go unto the camp of the Syrians. And when they were come to the outermost part of the camp of the Syrians, behold, there was no man there. Verse 8. And when these lepers came to the outermost part of the camp, they went into one tent and did eat and drink, and carried thence silver and gold and raiment, and went and hid it, and came again and entered into another tent and carried thence also, and went and hid it. Then said they one to another, we do not well. This day is a day of good tidings, and we hold our peace. If we tarry till the morning light, some mischief will come upon us. Now therefore come, that we may go and tell the king's household. Can you see in the city of Samaria starvation, famine? They had started eating one another, but there was abundance somewhere. Food, rice and stew, very plenty. Money, clothes, everything that life wanted was there in the camp, in another camp, in another settlement. The leper said, let's go there. Let's go. It's a fearful thing to go there because of what we have heard of them. But let's go. They came. The Lord did this miracle. They came and saw abundance. I am assuring you, in the name of the Lord Jesus, if you come over to this camp of holiness revival movement, you shall find abundance for your life. The love that you're looking for, you shall find it. The truth that you're looking for, you shall find it. The righteousness and holiness that you are looking for, you shall find it. Yes, I agree with you. Truth is falling on the street, but the flag of truth is raised up high in our midst. Love original is here. Righteousness and holiness, you will find it because the word of truth is here. The word of truth is here. Exemplary life of holiness is here. Don't mind what people are saying. Those are people who cannot walk in righteousness and holiness. They're the one talking all those vain words. The Lord has said clearly, don't mind what they're saying. The Lord is with us. The God of Jacob is with us. The Lord of hosts is with us. The eternal God is our refuge. He is here with us. The eternal world, the holy, holy, holy is with us. Things are happening around the world. Lives are changing around the world. Yes, people are making confession. You will see it right here now as the fire of God shall burn across you and begin to burn iniquity in your life. As the fire of God shall enter into your belly and expose witchcraft inside you. As the fire of God shall get hold of your private part and deal with immorality in your life. As the fire of God shall get hold of your tongue and burn falsehood, the lying tongue, and you cry out and say, Lord, save my soul. The presence of God is here. The power of God is here. Deliverance from Satan is here. Satan said, Jesus I know, Paul I know. Because Jesus is with Paul. Jesus acknowledges Paul. Paul was a man of holiness. And Satan knew it. The greatest power over Satan is not the power of fasting and prayer. The greatest power over Satan is the power of holiness. For the prince of this world cometh, and he findeth nothing in my life. You're welcome. I'm leading you to Jesus. I'm leading you to eternal life. I'm leading you to the well of love, the fountain of love. I'm leading you to the pillar and the ground of truth, the church of the living God, where you find the truth. I'm leading you there. Yes, come forth. We're going under the cross where righteousness reigns. Everything gets buried, gets destroyed. Iniquity is purged out. It's yours today. I'm taking you there. As I'm taking you there, the Lord shall have new names entering glory today. New names will be entering glory today. There shall be losses in hell. There shall be losses in hell. For you are coming out of hell. You are coming out of the power of hell. The grip of Satan over you shall be broken. You will be free. You will be free. Not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. Holy Ghost shall make a difference in your life. I congratulate you because you shall now be peaceful. You shall breathe the breath of release. You will be free. I say you will be free. I say you will be free. The blood of Jesus will walk on you. The name of Jesus will walk on you. The spirit of Jesus will walk on you. The power of Jesus will walk on you. And the result is that you are a new creature. Rise up upon your feet. You will be a new creature right away. Iniquity shall be no more. Satan's boasting over you shall be no more. Yes, open your mouth wide and I will fill it. Open your mouth wide and God will fill it for you. Yea, blessed are they that hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Jesus' name we pray. Prodigal sons are coming back home. A new garment of righteousness shall be put upon their life. The Lord shall embrace them. The Lord shall forgive iniquity. You are a sinner, you want to come back home. You want Jesus. Raise up your hand. We want to pray for you now. Yes, quickly, quickly. Yes, raise up those hands. You want Jesus in your life? Where are those hands? Just can you raise them and wait for me? Let me see. Very good. Yes, your Lord is seeing you. Your Lord is seeing you. Now, tell him you're sorry for your sins. Confess them. Mention them before him. I give you quickly little time before I bring you to him in prayer. Tell him yourself, Lord, I'm sorry. Lord, I'm sorry. Lord, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for my sins. I'm sorry for my iniquities. Forgive me, Lord. Mention those sins to him and promise you will go to them no more. You will commit them no more forever. Jesus' name we pray. Now, say these prayers after me, you who want Jesus. Lord Jesus, I need you in my life to heal me from sin, to give me the water of eternal life. Lord Jesus, open my eyes that I might see you. Open my heart that I might understand you. Give me your power to walk in your way. Clothe me with your righteousness. I have made up my mind today. I will walk with you. I will serve you. I will belong to you. Lord, hear my prayers. Don't allow the devil to remove me away. Jesus, deliver me. Jesus, break my yoke of sin. Save me, Lord. Thank you for hearing me. In Jesus' name I pray. Raise up your hand now, I'm praying to pray for you. You who confess this prayer in earnest. Divine, let your angels locate them and put in and remove from them the rack of prodigal living. Change their garments. Lord Jesus, give them the garment of righteousness. Thank you for answering our prayers. In Jesus' holy name, we pray. Give a clap offering to Jesus. He has saved you. He has saved you. He has delivered you. He has made you a new creature. Go and live in righteousness and holiness. You are not the same anymore. In Jesus' name we pray.
The message you have just listened to is a production of Holiness Revival Movement Worldwide. Holiness Revival Movement Worldwide is a non-denominational ministry that is given to the propagation of Christ's righteousness and holiness in churches and nations of the world through crusades, revival meetings, production and spread of holiness literature and materials. For other spiritual materials, messages or inquiries, contact us on 0816-902-3948 or 0805-683-4323. You can also reach us through our email address, holinessrevivalmovement@gmail.com. God bless you.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Hallelujah. Jesus, I believe in you. You are my Lord and Savior. I believe in you. You are the living Savior. I believe.
I believe in you. You are the living
Savior.
Jesus, I believe in you.
I believe in you.
You are my Lord and Savior.
You are my Lord and Savior.
Jesus, I believe.